my name is Debra Wheatman. I am the president and founder of Careers Done Right. We are a marketing and branding company for individuals, so we work with clients over time to help them plan, manage, and evangelize their careers. It's not the same thing today as it was when all of us were much younger and looking for work. I see some of you nodding. A lot of times they would say to you, well, we don't have this position right now, but we have something else that might be a good fit. How many of you heard that in the past? Right? You heard that, right? Yes, you heard that. Now they don't say that anymore. You have to have the exact description and it has to really match perfectly. And sometimes that doesn't even work. Who finds sometimes that does not even work? Right, it's sometimes you're like, what is going on? Why? Why not? It's perfect, I have everything. How many of you, by a show of hands, do not have a LinkedIn profile? Okay, so I see three hands. Anybody feel like sharing why they don't have a LinkedIn profile? Why don't you have one?
Privacy.
Why don't you have one?
I've been retired and I'm...
Now you're going back? Okay, all right. Those are not good enough reasons anymore to not have a LinkedIn profile. LinkedIn is a tremendous, powerful tool that can help you if you use it the right way. It is the largest business network. It's great for finding a job or locating opportunities that you might be interested in pursuing. You should always be networking. Continuing to build your network, keeping a presence not only on LinkedIn and other sites, but also networking in person is so important. You need to have a profile picture because people want to see who they're interacting with. Yes?
Many people, including myself, just have a straight shot with business clothes on. And others do something that has to do with background or hobby or something like that. Do you have any tips about when it's appropriate to...
You know, yes. Like, it would be ridiculous if I didn't. I saw someone just the other day who connected with me. He was holding, I guess, maybe it was his daughter in the picture or his granddaughter, which she's adorable, but there's no reason that you should have her in your picture. You want to have a professional headshot of just you. You don't need to spend a lot of money on a headshot. Plenty of people do and they get professional headshots done, which is totally fine. But if you don't want to do that, you don't have to. Get someone to take a picture against a neutral background, and you can use that as your LinkedIn profile picture. Plenty of people do it, and it looks absolutely fine. You can write your summary in the first or third person. What's that?
Can you repeat that whole sentence? You said, when you...
No. Really? Yes. When you write your summary, you can either do it in the first or third person. You don't want to include everything that's contained on your resume in your LinkedIn profile. Generally, what I recommend people do is take a short section from their responsibility portion of their resume for a particular position, and then have like 2 to 3 key achievements underneath. This goes back to these things serving as an appetizer. If you give your entire resume, or you upload your resume, which I also don't recommend, to LinkedIn, there's no reason for someone to necessarily call you. They have all of the information right there. Yes.
What I've done that works is I would give key people a recommendation, and then I'd ask them for a recommendation back.
Right. And you can certainly do that. You can absolutely do that. There is nothing wrong with that as well. But an easier thing to do is, if someone is offered to do it for you already, then the easiest thing to do is just write up a short recommendation, and then you can send it to them. Hi, Deb, I know you said you were going to do this for me. I know really that you're so busy that you don't necessarily have time to write this, so I wrote it. If you don't have any issues with it, feel free to post it, and they'll do that. It can happen on Facebook. I know it happens a lot on Google Plus. Does anybody have Google Plus? Does anybody use Google? I know you use it, Alex. I get these weird things on Google Plus, like all the time. If someone tries to join my circles on Google Plus, all of a sudden I get a note from them. How are you, my dear? It usually ends with my dear. I tend to stay away from Google Plus, although I think there's some value to it, but I haven't yet seen it other than, you know, people trying to take me out to dinner. Maybe Alex, you can, what do you find it? Because I know you're on it, so you, how do you
no
like?
No lady is inviting me.
No lady. I get the my dear message. Hello, my dear.
That was a good summer.
Your summer, your entire LinkedIn profile needs to have perfect spelling, flawless grammar, no typos, no joke. It must be perfect, just like your resume. So manager, manager, also a word. Public, without the L, also a word. I also blog regularly on LinkedIn. It's a good way to build your brand and establish a name for yourself in an area that you consider yourself an expert, and it will help other people understand your expertise in that same area.
Please speak about some guidelines, your thoughts about what kind of people you connect with.
Thank you for bringing that up, because I would have forgotten to tell you this story. So I see I have a connection request. I get a lot of connection requests. I accept, for the most part, I accept all of them and hope that, you know, I'm not connected to a serial killer. I always look at the profile first. I always look to see what's written there to make sure it's complete, whatever. This one particular connection, it just looked weird. She's asking me to connect with her. Her name is Beverly Washington. So I go and I do a reverse Google search and I find this picture of a person who, she's in the educational space. So whoever this Beverly Washington is, took this person's picture, put it up there as if it was her, and is potentially using this for nefarious reasons. What those reasons are, I have no idea. So of course I didn't accept her, and I quickly wrote to a connection of mine who was also connected to her. And I said, hey, just want you to know, this woman is not Beverly Washington. Here's a link to where you can see this picture. So you should disconnect from her. So this sort of leads into a long-winded explanation of Gary's question. When you go to LinkedIn, you look at people. Check out their profile before you accept them. I tell people regularly, using the internet for your job search is an after 8 p.m. activity. This is not an activity you should be engaging in during normal business hours. So somebody took me very literally and was like, well, I saw a position posted at noon, and if I waited, I wasn't gonna, that's not what I mean. Yes, of course apply at noon if you see it. What I'm talking about is general searching, using the internet to apply for jobs. You don't do that when you could otherwise be engaging with people and talking and getting out there. Thank you very much for joining me this morning, almost this afternoon now. Mm-hmm. I appreciate it. If you have questions for me, I'm happy to address your questions. Thank you very much. If you do want to connect with me on LinkedIn, I accept, as I said, all connections except Beverly Washington's. And I'm happy to make introductions to people in my network to help you expand your network and help you get the positions you desire.